guys to auto surgery. We have this vehicle, F150, 2010. I have these vehicles coming. This guy, he has a leak on the oil pan. Let me just show you guys. That's a big job. That's the oil pan right here. It's leaking. We have to replace that oil pan. You see that big leak? It's a big V8. Super cool. Ford F-150. So first of all, what we're gonna do now on this particular, I'm gonna join the oil. As you guys could see, all the leak. Everywhere he's leaking. I'm gonna join the oil. When I finish to join the oil, then I'm gonna take out this bar here. And we have this actual shaft right here from the differential, front differential. I'm gonna disconnect this piece here from the top. I will disconnect it. Then I will do the same thing for the right front too, the left front. Then after that, to have more space, I will take out this bar here, which is like the sway bar link. I'm gonna take it out completely to have access to that oil pan. And I'm still gonna make some space on that to take it out. All right, so let's start moving to that baby right now. Yes. We take out this oil first because that'll be much easier for us. The oil is dripping. While the oil is come out, I'm preparing my tools to take out the sway bar link completely down. So now I put this back. Now we're gonna take this guy out on our space. This post member here in the front, that one, this is 18, and the front, the one in the front is 15. So now we're just gonna move the cross member here. Take out the cross member. Now we have some space. So now, to make ourselves much easier, we're gonna remove this sway bar link right here. The sway bar. That one here, this is a 15. We're gonna remove the second one as well. I'm not gonna remove it completely, I'm just gonna leave it just the way it is like that, because I have enough space. So now we're gonna remove the big papa here in the front to have more space. Remove this big papa right here. That one 18, and the one is in the back is 21. A big bar right here. I'm gonna make sure we take it out completely. Once you take it out, then we get the second one. The second one on the left. Okay. She's off. So now we're gonna remove the second one right here on the top. Be connected to this one. Okay guys, this is a 13 millimeter. We have to take it out. Oh, those both will hold the oil pan now. All right, guys, this is it. So all the bolts coming out now. So this is the time to bring the papa down. There she is. Okay, so now I'm gonna look for more space. I have to bring this papa down a little bit to have access to it to come out. Just gonna slide this cable down here.
There's a gasket right here.
The gasket been here for so long. Then the gasket is stuck. There's a new one that I get from Ford. This is the number if you guys are looking for it. And I get this one as well from Ford too. Clean up under here. This is all where the piston is. So this is the time to look at this little pressure spot. This one to make sure if we have any, you know, like any some crazy thing could come out from here, which is like some steels could come off from here. Just to make sure everything is clean and look good. Then I'm gonna clean up the edge of the old gasket, clean it nice, and put the new gasket, and then put that papa inside, and then ready to go. All right. Just make sure, guys, we clean up all this old gasket part. Sometimes they stick. Once they stick, you don't have choice, you have to clean up. Because if you don't clean up it up, what's gonna be happening? The new gasket that you're gonna put on it, so it's not gonna do the job well done. So you have to redo it again. So a job like that, it's better to take an extra hours to clean up those old gasket, you know? You make sure you do a good job, you're happy with your job, and then customer not gonna come in back in your back again, you know? Customer not gonna come in back again for the same thing that you have done, and you knew How hard it is, it's not easy. Just make sure you clean it good. Make it nice and easy. So that I'm just gonna pass a little bit of sandpaper on it. And then ready to go. Okay, now I'm looking good. I'm just gonna wrap it up. Strap it up, clean it up. Clean it up with some rags. So you make sure you clean up nice. You're good to go. Everywhere on this one here. You can hear me back as well. Make sure. So now, I'm just gonna grab my sandpaper, just gonna pass it on it, just to make sure I'm good. Yeah, you're looking good. I'm gonna grab my sandpaper, and then after that, I'm just gonna pass some wick cleaner on it at the edge, then put that sexy end. Yeah. That's the same paper that I'm gonna just put in it, just to make it nice. So with that, I know I'm 100%. I'm good with it. Okay. Looking good. She's looking good. Perfecto. Si, papa. Okay, now I'm just gonna get the book cleaner. Pass the rags on it. Make it look nice. And then install it that sexy thing. That's the same paper that I'm gonna just put in it, just to make it nice. So with that, I know I'm 100%. I'm good with it. Okay.
You're looking good. She's looking good. Perfecto. Si, papa. Okay, now I'm just gonna get the boot cleaner. Pass the wax on it. Make it look nice. And then install it that sexy thing. Yeah, guys, this is the one she's already in. Actually, I put a little bit of anti-seize on it. This is me, I always put some little anti-seize on it, to put it in, and especially when it's got on tight. We'll do it hand tight first. I like to go with hand tight. No surprises on that. That's when I go with my hand tight first. So I keep going over and over, over and over, over and over. After that, don't forget the top specification, guys. This top specification is very important for this one. If you over tight it, you're in trouble.
Yeah. Do not over tight it because you don't want that thing is leaking. You do not want it leaking. Once you do it, you make sure you do it good. You take your time, you do it good. And we keep working.
Hand tight
all the time.
Keep going.
I'll double check again on my tightness if everything's looking good. You know, after when you took all day or your pen. Looking good.
It's tight and tight. That sex is stopping. It's tight and very nice. You know?
So now
We're on our way to put. Yes. Okay. Perfect. Looking good. Beautiful. Sexy mama, she's looking nice, great, you know, there she is right there. So now, it's the time to replace that big papa right here. To put on the hole right here, we're gonna push it up. First, we're gonna put some anti-seize here. Why you put anti-seize? So next time, if I have to do a job on that vehicle, or even though it's not me, that could be another technician, that would be easy for him to take it out, or her. Just like this guy here, like that, up. And then we slide it in like that, just like that. And we have that guy here in the back. Just like that, put it in. Alright. We put them just like that. And we start it up. I'm just gonna grab my 19 and to tie it. Guys, now we put in the new oil after changing this big oil pan. We're gonna start that vehicle to make sure they have no leaks on it. We'll do a wall test, then we're good to go. Okay guys, now we finish everything. Now we're going to check under the vehicle right now to see if we have any leaks before we do a wall test. As you guys can see under here, you're looking good, you're looking great. As you can see under here, you're looking good on the oil pan. So now we just need to do a wood test. After the wood test, we're gonna double check again. If we have no leaks, nothing, then we will call the customer to come pick it up. He's baby. Thank you guys for watching that video. I went to do a wood test on that vehicle. Everything went well. She's driving very nice and smooth. I'm so happy with that job that I have done. So now I'm just gonna call the customer and then pick up the vehicle. So hopefully that video will help someone, maybe a family member, a friend, you know, just give them a chance. So subscribe, please. Subscribe, guys. And if you have any question, put it under. Do not hesitate. And I will continue to put more video for you guys. So thanks for watching that video. Remember, Jesus is coming soon. Get ready.